Audio Jungle.
Welcome back to the Three Amigos podcast. My name's Lachlan, and I'm here with Archie Fathlin and Sean Rose. And on today's episode, we're talking about how the complexity of human emotion is portrayed in two fantastic films.
Hello, Lockie. Thank you for having me on this podcast today.
Yeah, good morning, Lockie. Thanks for having me as well. It's great to see you.
Line, directed by Gareth Davis, and September 11 by Sean Penn. The movie Line, directed by Gareth Davis, is based on the true story of Saru Beverly, who, at the age of 5, was separated from his family in India as he fell asleep on a train and woke up 1,600 kilometres away from his home. Saru was later adopted by an Australian couple, and after 25 years, he began searching for his Indian family. In contrast, September 11, directed by Sean Penn, is about a man who has lost his wife and continues to live a life with her even though she isn't actually there. He's reminded of his loss as 9/11 is displayed on the TV screen in front of her. Both films portray the complexity of human emotions in different ways, meaning that we as a viewer process them in different ways as well. Alright then, let us get started. Archie, how do you think the complexity of human emotions is shown in the film Line?
Thanks for asking, Lockie. I believe that he goes through the stages of human emotions and the complexities such as guilt and grief and the effects it has upon him. For example, in this scene, we see the main character Saru discovering his mother has died after his return to Calcutta. He processes these emotions by going through the regular stages of grief and anger, as he felt he was not able to help his brother the night he went missing. For all this, however, he begins his journey by going on a lifelong experience, trying to get back home and ending up adopted by an Australian family. I believe people process emotions in so many ways, and when I see it through the eyes of Saru Beverly, a young boy who gets separated from his brother and family, and the way he deals with his emotions is wasting no time and begins to search for his family, which eventually lands him deep in the heart of India and eventually gets caught up in a home for foster kids, and later flown to Australia where he lives out a good life, living in his house, constantly trying to connect dots, try and find his brother. We see this in a quote he says, and I believe the director uses English and language techniques through the use of metaphor in order to achieve his purpose of digging deep into Saru's emotions. We get to hear this in a scene where Saru is talking to Lucy about his past and brings up his emotions, and the acting really shows that I do believe, truly, that Dev Patel's acting is incredible, don't you think?
Thanks, Archie, for the great insight into how Line shows and portrays the complexity of human emotions in Line. I agree with the fact that the acting and language techniques the director uses to help support human emotions in this film. Now, Sean, how do you think it compares to how emotion is illustrated in September 11?
Line portrays guilt and grief through the character Saru's experience with loss and life. Identically, we see Ernest, the character in Sean Penn's September 11, express grief and guilt over the realization that his wife is gone. The emotion over the loss of his wife is similar to the loss Saru suffers over Gudu. During the movie, we see Saru's young character and his experiences within India. Saru is constantly cared for by his older brother Gudu. Because of this, the film makes it exceedingly clear the emotion of losing his brother and how that causes extreme grief and guilt. Saru calls out for Gudu once he wakes at the train station, the mirror image of Ernest calling out to his wife at the end of the movie. You can also see the past of Ernest, the main character of September 11, in the opening of the short film. He calls out to his wife. Ernest shows grief and guilt through many things, including the behavior before his acceptance over the loss of his wife. Both films portray guilt and grief through the tone of characters. However, although the the two films are very similar in the emotions they express. The difference in the way they express these emotions are clear. Saru, at the time of losing his brother, is much younger, so we see desperation in his voice. Compare this with September 11, where Ernest is clearly coming into acceptance of the status of his wife.
Thanks for the insight, Sean. Now, let's just go through some quick-fire questions to summarize these thoughts. So Archie, how do you think Saru shows human emotion and why is it so prevalent during his time with his adoptive family?
Yeah, look, I think that's a really great question. But I think the film implies that Saru forgot not only Hindu, but his childhood memories, which he slowly recovered as an adult. In the memoir, we learn that while he bonded immediately with his adoptive parents, feeling loved and safe even more, even before he could communicate with them in language, he never forgot his Indian family.
Interesting. Tell me please, Sean, how does Saru show grief towards others?
Saru shows grief through his behaviour. First, we see it during an intimate interaction with his girlfriend Lucy. In an emotional moment, he picks up a jalebi, an unattainable food item from India. This shows symbolism of his past. He slumps over the counter as he whispers the words, "I am from Calcutta," again referencing his home in India. This shows the audience that Saru's past still haunts him and that he truly has never felt at home. Again, we see this during the moments where he finds his home over the internet. How does Saru's behavior display his emotions?
Again, that's a really great question. About Saru's behavior? I guess in the movie Lion, it also portrays Saru's struggle with feelings of disloyalty of his adoptive parents because of his love and need for connection with his birth family. I think in Saru's memoir, it just suggests that growing up, he kept most of his memories and feelings about his birth family to himself.
How does September 11 display the complexities of human emotions?
September 11 shows the effects that such tragic events can have on a human brain and how we process these human emotions. In this case, we have Ernest thinking that his wife is home asleep and picking out clothes for her every morning. However, due to tragic events that have occurred around him, he is yet to realize until the end of the film that his wife is sadly not there with him anymore.
What film or language techniques are used to portray these emotions?
Emotive language is used a lot in this film. As the movie progresses, the sadness builds up and continues building up over and over until eventually we get the disastrous event of both towers collapsing, killing thousands, as well as the director choosing emotive language as it is able to evoke certain emotions. At the end of the short film, what does Ernest realize about his wife?
At the very end of the film, Ernest wakes up to fully grown flowers. So ecstatic with this revelation, he jumps at the opportunity to show them to his wife. Ernest repeats his wife's name multiple times, each time coming close to a sad realization. After the last time of calling his wife's name, the room falls silent, and Ernest's expression slowly turns. He realizes his wife is dead, and he breaks down. The film is excellent at showing sadness and grief through the character's tone and visual expressions. During the movie, we see Saru's adopted brother Mantosh deal with severe mental health issues. Why is this so important for the story to focus on, and how does it change Saru's character?
Yeah, I agree with that. Saru's mind has been changed on how his life was easy, and how he got off easy compared to others such as his brother. Saru doesn't like his brother for leaving him, and can't forgive his brother for what happened. However, after discovering his brother's death, he throws that all away. It also gives Saru some insight into his brother's journey, and always allows for character development. However, we don't see much of Saru's brother's journey, as we later find out he was hit by a train, and that's why he hence never returned to Saru.
A big part of the movie is the focus on Saru's desire to reconnect with his brother. Later, we see that his brother passed away. How does the focus on finding his brother affect him emotionally? And what is the significance of the revelation of his brother's fate?
It's a really tough question, Sean. But to give you the honest answer, I think Saru realizing that his brother has passed away, I guess really opens his eyes to how lucky he is to be so fortunate in the way his life went, and how Saru often probably didn't get the way he wanted it to by not being with his family, but I reckon at the end of the day, he still got to meet his mother. However, never seeing his brother again really made him realize how lucky he was.
That's all that we have time for today. I would like to thank Sean and Archie for the great insight into how the complexity of human emotions have been shown in two great texts. Lion, directed by Gareth Davis, and September 11 by Sean Penn. Thank you, Sean and Archie, for spending your precious time coming on today and giving your knowledge on how human complexity is portrayed in the film Lion and September 11th.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Lucky. Thanks for having me as well, Sean. Really appreciated the time we had today, and I think it was really great insight to Saru Briller's journey. And then explore the movie Lion and also Sean Penn's September 11th. I think it was a really helpful insight to both texts. So thanks for having me. I guess until next time, I'd love to be on the podcast again.
Thank you, Lockie and Archie. This has been an extremely insightful experience about the complexities of human emotion in the film Lion and September 11th by Sean Penn. Thank you for having me on today's podcast.
Let's start with where you're from.
Calcutta.
Which part?
I'm adopted. I'm not really Indian. I'm starting to remember.
Saru, you're a beautiful boy.
You're very proud of yourself.
A life I'd forgotten.